Good morning. It's 3:20 a.m. on Wednesday. I am recording this for a couple of reasons. One, I did record something last night at 9 o'clock. You would have seen how tired I was. But due to technical reasons, it didn't record the audio properly. So it was pointless. Just a bunch of me jabbering on without any sound, which I know a lot of people would probably appreciate. So it's... I will summarize what's kind of happened since Heathrow. Got onto the plane from Heathrow to Hamburg, British Airways. It was an A320 Airbus, smaller jet, much smaller than the 747 I had been on previously. And it had kind of started to rain fairly heavily in Hamburg, and more importantly, there were all kinds of clouds. So the long and the short of it is we were delayed our departure by about 30, 35, 40 minutes, something like that. But eventually we took off. And then something very funny happened on the plane. It was a British Airways flight, so all the flight attendants were all English. And, you know, midway through the flight, early on, they came down the aisle, and there was a first was a young lady about 25 years old, and then on the other side of the cart for the drinks and so on was a young guy, maybe 21, 22. And anyway, they came to the aisle in front of me, and the young fellow said to this girl, kind of teen, like late teens girl, early 20s, he said, you know, can I get you something to drink? And the girl, turned out to be an American, said, yes, a root beer, please. She said, yes, a root beer, please. And the English guy, he kind of turns his head like this and he says, what's that? And then his slightly older compatriot said, oh, I've had that in America. It's kind of like Coca-Cola, but tastes like mouthwash. So I almost started bursting out laughing. And then I said to her, I think it tastes a little bit better than mouthwash. And she says, oh yeah, a little bit better. So anybody in the world, by the way, listening to this who has not had a root beer, it's kind of like, more like Dr. Pepper, which I guess has gone around the world. It's not exactly the same as Dr. Pepper, but it's something like that. It's not Coca-Cola, but it's just a little bit different. Very sweet, very sweet. So that was nice. Other than that, the flight was uneventful. I charted the flight. They had the little computer monitor on there, you know, showing where we were. It was kind of 3D. And I kept on taking pictures of that map of where we were, and then I would take pictures of the clouds and the land below. But it was very cloudy, but some interesting cloud patterns, including the area where I believe a certain crazy Dutch friend, CDF, lives. But we shall see. I shall be told whether or not I captured the right area. So, got into Hamburg, and it was the most quiet concourse, if you will. There were hundreds and hundreds of people there, but everyone was so quiet. I don't know, this is just a German thing, but it was very orderly. I enjoyed it. Rather than some places in Canada or US or Mexico or whatever, where it's just a lot more yammering, which is very quiet. Maybe if it was World Cup or some other football game, as in soccer, it would be more lively. I walked down the aisle, went to the restroom, walked down the aisle, then I had to go through a police checkpoint because I realized that I hadn't actually gone through customs in Heathrow. That was just a security check. So I went through, and there was a very nice a lady there, a customs lady, and she says, yes, the purpose of your visit? I guess I was so tired. I kind of went on and on and on. Oh, it's the first time I've been here in 20 years. Oh, my dad's from Silesia and so on. Just, anyway, she just smiled. Just stamped my passport. And what a goofball. She didn't say that, but... Anyway, so then I walked further, got my bag. It was right there, my one check-in bag. And then went to the exit, and there was Nadine. Big smile, big hug. And then she took a picture of me kissing the ground, or what looks like I was kissing the ground of the airport. But it was a nice long journey. It was the end of a nice long journey. So then we went to her car, beautiful Volkswagen Golf, like I had, but hers is newer and cooler. And Hamburg Airport, by the way, it's so slick. Like, it's very, Vancouver's nice too. I guess I'm saying from the outside, it's just very, very modern, this Hamburg Airport. So then we started driving through the city. It was kind of raining or about to rain, but I guess it was raining. And I was just like she had forgotten, I guess, temporarily how many photos I take. So I was just taking all kinds of crazy photos of everything I could see. But you don't see taxis that are Mercedes every day back in Vancouver. You never see them. And just, all the lovely German words like Platz and Schön, and it was just great. So she gave me kind of a mini tour, and oh my God, it's such a beautiful place. I was telling her that my only knowledge of Hamburg really is my own research, seeing what photos I've taken. I'm seeing online, and then what my friend Daniel Croteau, who had visited here and stayed with Nadine before, had told me, and so you kind of have like a picture in your mind, and so some of that I saw, some of that I was the same, but it was just so much bigger, and the buildings were bigger, and it's just so much more expansive than I ever dreamed. It was truly amazing, and if I do happen to be here on one of the days when it's sunny out, don't know if that'll happen while I'm here, but I would love to walk around downtown again, and just it's such a beautiful place, and so much history as well. And so anyway, I'm totally in love with the city. I just arrived, totally in love. So she parked downtown, and then we went to a place. It was called Block JB. There was like a block house or something to that effect. It was like a steakhouse, and the next door was this Block JB, which was more of a hamburger joint, Junior Burger. I don't know. But I thought, hey, that's kind of appropriate, having a hamburger in Hamburg. But it was a very delicious hamburger. It was fantastic. And so I had that, and of course I had a beer. You and Jerry went in Rome, and it was very delicious. And just I was, just starting to, the fatigue was starting to clear me. So then, finished up, and then she drove me to the hotel, and it's a Best Western. They say it's a 3-star. I got it from either Hotwire or Priceline. I don't remember, but it's a nice place. I mean, it's a nice enough place, but compared to back home, you wouldn't say this is a 3-star hotel. It would be like a 2 to 2.5 star. And again, I'm not complaining. It's a lovely place, but the room here. I'll just give you a little scan of the room here. It's very, very small.